Welcome to Signing Day Live. Coming up over the next 2 hours, the latest on Virginia Tech's 2015 football recruiting class. We will hear from the insiders, including Tech assistant coaches Bryan Stinespring, Bud Foster, and Scot Loeffler. Plus, we'll introduce you to seven of the newest Hokies as we go one-on-one with our mid-year enrollees. We'll bring you objective analysis of the Hokie signing class with 247 Sports national recruiting analyst Barton Simmons. Mike Burnham and Andrew Allegretta will hit the telestrator to break down Tech's nice top signees. And Director of Athletics Whit Babcock will join us as well live to talk about the latest events. It is a full 2 hours of Virginia Tech football on one of the biggest days of the year. And it begins right now on this year's edition of Signing Day Live. And good morning, everyone. Welcome to this year's edition of Signing Day Live, coming to you from Blacksburg. Over the next 2 hours, we will break down Virginia Tech's 2015 signing class, introduce you to seven mid-year enrollees, and get expert analysis from Mike Burnup. Later, Whit Babcock will join us as well, Virginia Tech's Director of Athletics, and I'll be joined by Tech's coaches as well. We start things off, though, today with the newest member of Virginia Tech's football staff. It is Chuck Cantor, Virginia Tech's Director of Player Personnel for football. This is such a big day for Tech's program, a successful day, it appears, as well. Welcome to the show. What should we expect today?
You know, it's been an exciting morning so far. I think the first one rolled in at 7:01 this morning, and you know, it's really been a great, exciting day. You know, it's really been great since I've got here in the middle of June, early July, and you know, it's really been action-packed with this, kind of been you know, race to the finish line here.
Chuck, tell us about your role specifically as Virginia Tech's football director of player personnel.
Gotcha. You know, one of the big things that when Coach Beamer brought me in here and John Belin. Was to increase our exposure on social media and with the technology and really allow our coaches to really coach and recruit and, you know, us handle everything else off the field. And I think that's really went really good for us this year. And signing day was today was one of those opportunities to look at the technology that's, you know, really helped us today. In the past, we've always used the fax machine. And today we went to using text messaging in the picture of the NLI. We've went to scanning and emailing in the NLI and grant and aid. So it's really been an exciting day, and you know, been able to utilize some new technology today. And you know, I know some of the recruits really liked it. So
it's very exciting. In fact, there's so many exciting things that are happening on campus right now. This has been a great day for Virginia Tech football. We usually think football games are won and lost in the fall, but they're really won today. And there's so much exciting stuff happening on our campus right now for our recruits.
Yeah, I really think there's some, you know, great, exciting things happening for us, you know, with the indoor facility, you know, expected completion here in the early part of the summer. So really excited for that and, you know, getting people inside that and getting our current team to be able to utilize that. And I know Coach Gentry is going to utilize that part of the strength program and also us using that for practice opportunities. So, you know, there's really some exciting things happening you know, right here on campus. And, you know, just today's class is really exciting. You know, at the end of the day, I think we'll end up with 24 expected guys. And we're really, really excited, you know, about everybody coming in with the class.
All right, as our show continues, we're going to break down the young men who have signed at Virginia Tech. You're going to have the opportunity today to meet personally the seven mid-year enrollees. Plus, later today, Mike Burnup and Andrew Allegretta will break down via telestrator the key guys in this year's recruiting class. Plus, objective analysis once again this year. The national recruiting analyst for 247 Sports will join us to talk about exactly how the Hokies did and how recruiting went in the ACC. So stay tuned. Coming up, we've got much more. It is Signing Day Live 2015. And when our show continues, we're going to go through some social media aspects for you as well. If you'd like to shoot a question to our coaches via Twitter, you can do that as well. Bryan Stinespring will join us next, the Hokies recruiting coordinator, when Signing Day Live continues from Blacksburg after these messages.
Cheeseburger pizza?
Boy, did I hear about it. And Big Bill 7 writes, "Are you kidding me? No more cheeseburgers on a pizza? Are you kidding me?" They're back, Big Bill. Bacon.
Are you kidding me?
Introducing the new Bacon Cheeseburger Pizza. Get a large for $12. And add our new double chocolate chip brownie for only $6 more.
Better ingredients, better pizza, Papa John's.
It's good.
Don't worry, honey.
I've got Mr. Biggles. He's safe and... Ow!
Go to your happy place, Daddy.
Happy place. Happy place.
When you bank with Union, it just feels good. You get free checking, there's no minimum balance, and no hidden fees.
I feel good.
Cute cat.
Do you need help getting down?
I got this.
When you're ready to feel good about where you bank, bank at union.com.
When you're looking to invest in a hardwood floor, you do all the right things, and so do we. We go straight to the mill, so you get the highest quality flooring at the lowest possible price. We offer great brands like Bellawood, which is backed by a transferable 100-year warranty. Over 2 million families have come to trust our flooring and the hardwood experts who help them realize their dream. Let us help with yours. Lumber Liquidators. Hardwood floors for less.
Welcome back to Signing Day Live. Great to have you with us. You know, you saw that season tickets will be going on sale this spring. As a matter of fact, if you are a season ticket holder, season ticket renewals begin on March the 2nd, and you can sign up to receive ticket information. I know you want to see this schedule this year, starting with Monday Night Football when the Buckeyes come here. On Labor Day Monday, there's the website. Log on. Get your season tickets. Hey, we've got some breaking news right at the top of the show today to get to. Deshaun McLeish, running back from Oscar Smith High School in Chesapeake, has signed a national letter of intent to play football here at Virginia Tech. Tremendous high school program. We'll get to McLeish in a bit later in today's show, show you some video of him as well. But now, let's welcome to our show Hokies recruiting coordinator and veteran coach, assistant here at Virginia Tech, Bryan Stinespring. Exciting day, isn't it?
Absolutely. It's you put a lot of time and effort into this, and it's not just a January, February operation or December, January. It is a year-long process, sometimes two, sometimes three, to get to that point and to finally get here and have these young men join us. It's an exciting time, absolutely.
So many players to talk about. If you could wrap up the recruiting class overall, how do you think we did?
Oh, I always thought we did very well, and where we really wanted to strengthen ourselves and we put a lot of emphasis was at the line of scrimmage on both sides of the ball. And I think if you look at where we are at the defensive end and defensive tackle and the number of offensive linemen we brought in here or are continuing to bring in here today, I think you see where our emphasis was for us in this particular recruiting class, and I think it paid off for us today.
All right, we are going to go through each prospect, show you some video, and get the coach's analysis once again this year. We're going to start with Austin Clark. Coach, fill us in on Austin.
Well, you know, Austin is a big offensive lineman. We were looking for some length here, and we found it in Lexington, Virginia. Probably a little side story to this thing, Austin. When I first got out of James Madison University, I started coaching at Lexington High School, and the quarterback we had there at that time was a guy named Stephen Clark, and that's Austin's father. So, you know, you've been doing this for a long time when you're starting to recruit some of your players' children. But Austin, big guy, a lot of length to him, had committed to another school early on. We stayed in there with him and really give Stacy Sorrells a lot of credit, building a relationship there and keeping that going. But we need him. He's here already. That bodes well for a guy that we may try to get ready to play or will try to get ready to play for us in the fall. And just really like his size and his movement and his length. And that's something we really concentrated on. We wanted to be able to get some tackle-type bodies in here.
Austin Clark, offensive lineman, 6'6", 297 from Rockbridge County. Now, as Coach Stinespring mentioned, he's already enrolled here at Virginia Tech. And our own Andrew Allegretta had a chance to visit with Austin. Let's take a look.
All right, Bill, thank you very much. Austin, let's start off with the basics. Why Virginia Tech for you? Well, I just felt like it was a place, you know, as close to home as I can get in the college. And I just felt really comfortable with the whole coaching staff and the strength staff. So it's pretty much as close to home as I could get.
And you're really close with Coach Stinespring, no?
Yes, I'm very close with Coach Stinespring. He actually coached my dad in high school, so there's kind of a little connection there.
He's a guy that's swung by the family house a time or two, no?
Yeah, he used to come by a few times. When he was in the neighborhood, he'd come by, check in on my dad and see how he was doing, things like that.
Now, Caleb Ferris went to your high school as well. What has he told you about this process, becoming a Virginia Tech Hokie, and his advice to you?
Well, through the whole recruiting process, he was just open and honest with me, and he'd let me know how he felt. And he told me, you know, he felt like there was no better place than Tech. And now that I'm here, I agree with him. And through this whole thing with me enrolling early and everything, he just let me know to work my butt off and take every opportunity I can to get better.
And so your position coach is Coach Searles. You're listed as an offensive tackle. What do you think your best position is? Maybe what has he told you about where you could play on that line?
Well, Coach Searles has definitely told me he wants me as a tackle, and that's where I'd like to play preferably. But honestly, I'd be willing to play guard if that's what gets me in sooner.
No doubt about it. Everybody wants to see the field, that's for sure. When you first get here, you're talking about working out, getting in there, getting Gentry-sized. Mike Gentry, the strength coach for Virginia Tech. What have they told you about where they want you to be physically?
Well, they want me to add on about 5 or 10 pounds. Right now I'm about 285, 290. They say they want me at about 297, 300, around that area. And that's why one of the reasons I came in early was so I could get in the weight room the whole semester earlier.
How have those workouts been so far?
They've been pretty hard, I'm not going to lie, but they've definitely helped me a lot, and I can definitely tell I'm going to benefit greatly from them.
All right. Hey, I'll leave you with this question. When I say Labor Day, Monday night, Ohio State, what do you think?
Victory. That's it.
All right. I hope that holds true. Thank you very much, Austin Clark. Bill, back to you.
All right, thank you, Andrew Hill. He's a good-looking prospect, isn't he?
He is. As I told you, we were looking for some length guys and some height guys that have that size. And Austin fits the bill. And the fact that he's already here with Mike Gentry and that strength and conditioning staff really helps us a great deal. It's important to get right here.
Yeah, no doubt about it. That'll give him a head start. All right, Steiny, I want to keep on this offensive line theme as we go to our next prospect now, Mike Arnold, 6'5", 280, from Winter Haven High School in Winter Haven, Florida, a first-team Florida All-State player. Tell us about Mike Arnold from Florida.
Again, keeping with the theme that we got here in the offensive line, we wanted to get some tackle-type bodies, guys that have some length, that can play out on the edge. You sit here and you watch Mike's movement abilities for a 6'5", 285-pound guy right now. That's two really good commodities to have, length and be able to move. And it helps a lot on that edge to be able to play out there in space. And we feel like Mike also gives you that opportunity to see a guy that can run and move, to get out in space, to get to the next level, to the linebacker level, to make key blocks down the field, those home run blocks that we're looking to make. He can pass protect. He's in a really good program. And the thing, again, here's a guy that committed to us and withstood a lot of late runs by some schools, including LSU and schools of that nature, and he stood firm with us. And that means a great deal in this time and age, Mike. Bill really does.
How do you evaluate a high school offensive lineman? When you look at the tape that our fans are watching right now, specifically, what do you look at, Coach?
You know, it's a great question because I believe still, and Stacy and I go back and forth on this, J.B. Grimes, we still talk quite a bit about this. It's still the toughest position, I think, we think, to evaluate. There's so many factors that you look at, but when you get right down to it, what body type are you looking for? For us, we were looking for an offensive tackle in that 6'4", 6'5", mode. We wanted some length guys from that standpoint. And then, as always, their movement ability and flexibility. Their ability to be able to move, their foot speed, their quickness, to change direction, because defenses are playing fast. You watch our defense and all the movement and the speed that they have. We have to have guys that can play against that as well.
We've seen Clark and Arnold. You guys project them both at least initially as tackles.
We do, absolutely. We need to strengthen that spot and provide some depth there as well.
All right, let's move on to our next prospect, and this is a guy that Hokie fans are familiar with. And familiar with his daddy as well. It is Coleman Fox from Salem, Virginia. Salem High School, his dad, Rich Fox, a tremendous fullback here for Coach Beamer, a second-generation Fox.
Absolutely, and we love that about him. But there's so many other factors that you love about Coleman. What a terrific young man. He does it right in the classroom, the way he carries himself, his entire demeanor, and how he just carries himself, and the way he approaches his school, the way he approaches football. He's a really good athlete. He can do it all. You see him here for Coach Magenbauer's team that they played in the state championship. And he runs the ball. He can catch the ball. He plays defense. There's so many things that he can do. He has a pretty big skill set, special teams, all those things that you look for in a football player. And I'll tell you, I went by twice when they got into the playoffs, and he had a really significant ankle sprain, one of those high ankles that it was swollen. There was many times I went through there, and I questioned, how's this kid going to play this weekend? But by the time Saturday rolled around, he was there, and there's something about that. You know, his competitive ire and the way he wants to be on the field with his fellow teammates, that's important.
We're looking at Virginia Tech recruit Coleman Fox. You guys have him listed as an athlete. Where does he project? What position?
I think there's a couple spots. As you watch this film, there's certainly a couple spots that he can play. I think we'd like to start him off at tailback. You want to get the ball in his hands. He's productive with the ball in his hands. You start him off and see how it fits there. Opportunity to get him in and out of the backfield and play out in space and play a slot receiver as well. There's a diversity level to him that allows him not to just be pick to one spot. I mean, if he comes in at tailback, he can carry the ball. If you want to move him out into space and use him as a receiver, he can do that as well. That diversity and versatility is important.
He was the Timesland Player of the Year as a senior. That was an honor from the Roanoke Times. And he played for a great program. He led his team to the VHSL championship game this past year.
He certainly did.
Over the years, the Hokies have had some great players from Salem as well. I always like it when you get the local kids. They're, you know, talking about what part of Virginia has the most prospects, and it certainly centers around the population bases. But when there is a star, over the years, the Hokies seem to get one from the Roanoke Valley.
Well, we've been very fortunate to be able to recruit the Roanoke area and what we call our home area. And again, Salem had a fantastic year this year as well as the tradition that they have in that program, and what Coach Magenbauer and back to Coach White have accomplished there has really been outstanding.
You know, his father, Rich, played for Tech from 86 to 89. How unique is it? Maybe this is a better question for Coach Beamer, that you get to coach the player and then you get to coach his son. This isn't the first time it's happened, but it's a tradition that we're continuing here.
Well, it's something we're very proud of. We talk about the number of brothers that have followed, younger brothers that have followed the older brothers, and we have that again today. But have that father-son combination. I tell you what's special about it, Bill. Watch the father see his son on an official visit. You watch the look in Rich Fox's eyes when he's here for the weekend and sees his son here at Virginia Tech. It's priceless, I promise you.
Oh, I know. I mean, Bruce Smith, we can't get him off the sidelines now.
He's in the meetings. They really are. Just to watch these guys and to see the pride that they have, not only in their own child, but the school that they greatly love. It's wonderful to watch. It really is. I get a lot out of it, just seeing their face.
Now, the reason that Coach Stinespring is so excited today, well, there are a lot of reasons, but the Hokies signed two tremendous tight end prospects that you're going to get a chance to coach. Let's start, Coach, with Xavier Burke from Fork Union, Lawrenceville. He started at Brunswick High School, 6'4", 250. Tell us about Burke.
Well, first of all, I've known Xavier for a long time. Again, as you said, alluded to, he was at Brunswick, led him to a state championship game. When he was a senior, went to Fork Union. I like everything about Xavier. I like not only the quality of play and his upside, but the person, his family. It has been a joy and a pleasure to get to know his family. They've made recruiting so much fun, and sometimes it is so stressful and pressurized the majority of the time. But just being around this group and watching how they operate as a family and how Xavier approaches it. I was just asking today, how is he doing down in the weight room, because he's already here. They are so excited about what he does down there and his approach to Virginia Tech and his work habits. That's going to mean a whole lot. You know, there's a lot of discussion with Xavier. You see his hands right there. He's a basketball player. He's got a tremendous skill set. He has size. He can run. Obviously, Coach Wiles and I have debates on where he's better equipped.
Well, what about that? Because he was named All-State as a defensive end as well.
Yes.
So where do you see him? We're watching him in action. Look at him here at the tight end spot, but he could play defensive end as well.
Exactly. He can. And he probably played more defensive end at Fork Union and probably played more defensive end as a senior in high school. He's played both. You know, this time I'm going to use a trump card. I recruited him. I'm going to give him.
There he is.
I'm going to get a chance to see if we can start him off here tight end and go from there and see. Again, though, Bill, I think the point we want to recognize here is guys are not just pinpointed to one area. those guys that have the versatility to play other spots, like with me, if I couldn't have played right guard, my next stop was the bus stop. You know, there was nowhere else for me to go. These guys like that, they bring some versatility to where they can play.
I think you're underestimating your athletics.
No, not a bit.
As a player. Xavier has already enrolled here at Virginia Tech. He was one of the seven mid-year enrollees, and he had a chance to visit with Andrew earlier. Let's take a look.
All right, Bill, thanks again. Here with Xavier Burke. You just spent the past semester at Pork Union Military Academy, of course, a place a lot of Hokies have gone before. Is there something on the field, on the football field, you feel like you're a better football player because of your time at Pork Union?
You know, Pork Union really helped me out a whole lot. I think I'm stronger and I'm older now in the game. I understand a whole lot more. My technique has gotten a whole lot better, and I'm just a student of the game now. I perfected my craft at Pork Union, and I continue to carry it on here at Virginia Tech.
All right, so you're listed a lot of times as a tight end, but you've played both sides of the football. Yes, how much on both sides and what positions?
Most of the time I've played a lot of, at Fork Union, I've played a lot of defensive end, and also through my high school career. Usually I play a lot of tight end at camps, but not a lot of tight end in high school football.
All right, so we were talking about this beforehand. We were talking about your time on the defensive line. You feel like you're fairly solid there. Is there someone you watch in the NFL where you go, man, if I'm not going to be a tight end, I'm going to be on the defensive line, that's going to be my guy?
I just love watching J.J. Watt. You know, his effort every play is just tremendous. He goes and get it, man. His technique, he's so good because he does his technique every play, and I just love watching him.
What are areas of your game right now you feel like, I do a really good job of this, but at the same time, maybe something the coaching staff is telling you, whether it's Coach Stinespring, I know he recruited you, that they want you to work on here in this first semester?
I would say my route running in my hands, but I have a very high motor. You know, I go hard every play. Effort isn't coached. So if you have effort and a lot of heart, and you can get far in this game.
All right, so hopefully you bring that winning attitude here to Virginia Tech. We'd love it.
Yes, 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 yes.
Xavier, thank you. Bill, back to you.
Good-looking prospect. Now, we've known that this kid was going to be a Hokie for a long time. He committed way back, what, as a sophomore?
Right after sophomore season, he came up to a camp that summer. I liked his sophomore film and then saw him, got him up to the camp and just really liked everything about him. And you knew that there was this potential and this upside value to him and just the way he carried himself. We offered him in. He committed.
And, yeah, July of 12. So Brunswick High School.
Yes.
That's a great prospect out of a high school like that.
No question.
All right, now, during the course of the show today, we're going to take some questions from you out there. You can tweet us your questions. First question, Coach Stinespring, this is from White House West. We can tell what they're doing in D.C. today. Where does this recruiting class rank among the top classes at Virginia Tech? Wes Morgan sent that into you, Coach.
Well, appreciate the question, Wes, but I don't know that you're really going to like this response because I've always said, and we've always felt, that you gauge a recruiting class not from the day that they sign, but 2 to 3 years down the road, and then rank them and see what type of class, because there's a lot of factors that go into the class and the longevity of the class and how guys grow and mature, because that's a big part of it, and develop. So to sit and gauge this class right now upon a signing date, we're excited about them. We think it's an outstanding class that fits exactly what we were looking for, but to say where does it rank with previous classes, I think you got to give it time.
Let's go to Joshua. He's also sent in a question from Twitter. Joshua says, Coach, who is our best defensive recruit?
Oh, boy, Joshua, you're trying to get me in trouble here. Have you seen some of these defensive guys? I'm not going to say one guy and another guy grabbed me when I walked down the hallway, but I think there's some really good defensive players in that mix. And, you know, I look at that defensive line and the guys across the board there that we have committed or have signed in here today. And there's a lot of what's good about it is there's a lot of guys to choose from and a lot of good choices to make in there. I really like Mook because I've just been around him so much, and I like him as a defensive player, and I like him he's going to be my assistant recruiting coordinator one day. He's very involved in that part of it too. So, you know, I'm partial a little bit to him because I've been around him so much a lot probably, but I'm not going to sit here and pinpoint one guy specifically. I got to walk back into that locker room.
It's exciting. Bud Foster will be here later. Maybe we'll throw that at Bud as well. Hey, let's get to another tight end prospect, and it is Chris Cunningham, 6'3", 225, from Jacksonville, Florida's Atlantic Coast High School, rated as the number 11 tight end in the country by ESPN. Coach, tell us about Chris Cunningham.
What we really like about Chris, and there's a couple things, but there's a skill set, his athletic ability. You see the versatility in him, but also within the group. Xavier's a bigger, longer guy. Chris is more of the H-back type guy that you're seeing us play more and more with. And you like those guys that can do both. But Chris is just a really good athlete. He can run well. He's got really good hands. And he's productive after the catch. He's not just a catch-it-and-go-down guy. He's a catch-it-and-get-positive yardage. He catches the ball very easily, transitions to the next level of play. As you see right there, that's what you're talking about, the yards after catch that you don't see a lot out of tight ends, and he's willing to stick his face mask in there and use his feet to be a productive blocker as well. So really just like his athletic ability is the first thing that stuck out, and he's going to get bigger and stronger, but you know, there's certain things that he does, especially the things when he catches the ball after the catch to increase the play.
Steiny, this is the second prospect from Florida that we've talked about among the first five kids. Hope he's got back into Florida this year.
Well, I don't think we've ever really left. I think we just had some success there, and you get with the play of Luther Maddie and Daddy Nicholas and Isaiah Ford and those type things. And I think he's still transitioning into the strength of some of your coaches in the recruiting areas and the recruiting staff with Torian and Charlie being able to free up a little bit more down to get back down there more. And then even with Lefty, who has ties down into Florida from his days at the University of Florida and recruiting down there. So it's helped the process to be able to enable us to do a little bit more recruiting down there. And it's paid off.
All right, lots more to get to with Coach Stinespring. We want to hear from you as well. Tweet us your questions. We're going to run through more of our 2015 National Letter of Intent signees at Virginia Tech when Signing Day Live continues in a moment.
And the freedom to actually use it. It's 2 gigs of data with unlimited talk and text for only $25 a month.
We're coming back spring game.
And zero down on all smartphones. Get the phones you want and save money every month. We'll even buy out your contract. And Telos, wireless for the people.
Gunderman Group.
Gunderman Group is growing.
Getting in a groove.
Growth is gratifying.
Goal is to grow.
Gotta get greater growth.
I just talked to UPS. They've got expert advice, special discounts, new technologies, like smart pickups. They'll only show up when you print a label, and it's automatic. We save time and money.
Time?
Money?
Time and money.
Awesome.
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 I love logistics.
Coming to Bristol Motor Speedway in 2016 is a college football showcase unlike anything the world has seen before. Fans from Virginia Tech and Tennessee have lobbied for years for the two schools to play at the world's fastest half mile. It will be the biggest college football game ever. That wait is finally over.
Signing Day Live 2015. You saw the season ticket promo right there, but don't forget the spring game is coming up as well. Make your plans to be at Lane Stadium for the spring game, the Maroon White game, April 25th at Lane Stadium. The kickoff is at 2:00. Admission is free. If you're just joining us, welcome to the show, Signing Day Live. I'm here with the Hokies recruiting coordinator, Bryan Stinespring. You've got a smile on your face. What fans don't see is you've got your iPhone here. It is exploding as always.
Yes.
You never stop. People are very excited about what they're seeing and what they're hearing so far today.
Well, I apologize for my voice. I was on the phone all night long last night, up until about 11:30 last night, and then started again this morning. I talked to Coach Magenbauer at 6:30 this morning. And then you get excited. So I want to talk about it, and I got a few other things to do today. But it's an exciting time, Bill. It really is.
I'm excited. Let's talk about our next prospect. He is from Ocean Lakes High School in Virginia Beach, and it is Jahkay Allen, safety, 6'1", 180 pounds. Tell us about Allen, Coach.
I really like Jahkay Allen. They won the state championship. Chris Scott and his program have been fantastic, and had a really good football team, and he was a major catalyst in this football team. Like his length, he's a good 6'1". He can run. He plays both sides of the ball. He's got great ball skills. I think it's one of the things that Torian and we've always liked is his ball skills. He can go get the football. He knows how to attack the play. You see his range here as a safety. And, again, that's a big-time play, right? To be able to go redirect, go find the football. He's a smart football player. He understands the game. He makes a lot of the calls back there. And you can see he comes up and fits on the run game as well. Not afraid to, again, you're going to see him out of his skill set as a receiver. Tremendous ball skills as a receiver. Again, I think this guy can play both sides. I know that Torian has been down to see him a couple times, and he likes the defensive part of it too. But you know, we got to do a really good job with this guy and get him on the field, that's for sure.
He's one of five defensive backs that the Hokies signed. You continue to do a really good job attracting elite players, corners and safeties up here.
We do. I think we have a tremendous reputation, obviously. That's well known in our back end. And we need to. People ask, you know, you recruited defensive backs last year and you got four or five this year, but you got to understand that you're playing more than just three and four defensive backs. The four defensive backs is not really the norm anymore. You're playing five defensive backs in the series now as opposed to just four. And so now you got to play the nickel and the dime packages. So you got to keep those numbers up, and you're getting ready to get a couple guys that are in that junior, senior year here at Virginia Tech. So we need to keep that tradition going, and Jahkay is able to do that. You can see, again, he can run. There's a length value to him that we really like.
What do you look at when you see one of these kids on tape right there? What stands out most to Allen?
His ball skills. I mean, obviously, we sit here and we'll watch him pick a ball off. You see him catch it, or you see him run, and just his ability to go find the football. It's a commodity that you don't talk a whole lot about, but when he's able to backpedal in the range that he shows to go cover a ball, to actually get there and then make a play on it, big time stuff.
Next prospect that we want to introduce to you is from Salem, Virginia, and Salem High School. Our next prospect is Zachariah Holt, who is committed to Virginia Tech. Coach, another Salem Spartan turned Hokie.
This is a process here. What we like about Zachariah Holt is he's a physical guy inside. He has size. He's 6'4". He's 285 pounds right now. You see him at the point of attack. There's a toughness. He's a physical ball player. And watch him run here. He's leading the charge down the field. And Stacy and I went by to see him a couple different times, watching him practice. This is a guy that the reason that you go back and reevaluate guys in their senior year. And I don't think it's things that we or as a staff across the country do a great job of, but you know, him being close by, Coach Magenbauer calling me, telling you need to come down and take a look here, and we watched him, and you watch it. This is a physical kid that moves really well, and he plays the game. He's got the size that you're looking for, and we were able to get him offered, and he just got back from his visit to BYU and he's Pittsburgh, and we're fortunate to get this young man. We're really excited about it.
One of four offensive line prospects that Virginia Tech signed today, Zachariah Holt from Salem, 6'3", 291. Let's go to the defensive side of the ball and go back to the 757 Hamptons Phoebus High School. Harry Lewis, defensive lineman, 6'2", 260. It's great to have another kid from Phoebus joining the Hokies program.
There's no doubt. You go back and get one of those programs throughout our time here, and that is a tremendous program and a great tradition of football at that school. And Harry's just a one of those guys that has come through that program and plays well, plays the game the way it's supposed to be played, has quickness, love his feet. He has the quickness that we're looking for defensively. He has a playmaking ability that we look for defensively. He uses his hands well. He's been well coached. So he understands the game. So we like his impact that he's going to bring inside.
Harry Lewis, defensive line, listed at 6'2", 260. For a prospect like that, he comes in and plays tackle. Where do you see him initially?
I think we're going to start him off at tackle initially with and get him moving quickly in that direction. Obviously, with Coach Gentry and our food and nutrition experts, we can get that weight on him. You see what we've accomplished in the past with some of those guys. But we really, I think he becomes a really good athlete inside.
You can scroll on the left side of your screen there and see all the prospects that the Hokies have signed already today. But we've got some more questions from the Twitterverse. Are you ready for some more?
I'm ready for the Twitterverse.
All right, Kevin, via Twitter, I see only three guys in this class from the 757. Do you think the addition of Coach Zondverden will help bring more kids from the Hampton Roads area?
Absolutely. And I thought we did a nice job in that area this year from the recruiting standpoint. But, you know, when we go to hire somebody or look to hire somebody, one of the aspects that we look at is what else do they bring to the table other than coaching your position. Obviously, that's the foremost area that you're concerned about. But from a recruiting value, from a recruiting standpoint, where does a guy bring some what does he bring to the table? And I think Zon brings a tremendous amount to us from that standpoint.
Another question from Twitter sent in from Scot Staley. Coach Stinespring, what do you see as the key strength in the signings today?
Again, I think there's really two components I look at when we think of this thing. I think the key strengths in this class, again, is I thought we were able to answer needs in recruiting and in signing day. It's a needs-based deal. That's part of the equation. And at the line of scrimmage on both sides of the ball, I thought we were able to answer that well. We created some length in the back end. If you look at our defensive backs, most of them are 6 foot or higher. So we wanted to try to create some length in the back end of our secondary, which I thought we were able to do. And then again, you know, going back to the line of and then get a quarterback. I think that was very critical, as always, in any class.
No doubt. Yeah, we'll talk. Coach Loeffler is coming up in a bit. We'll have an opportunity to look closely at the quarterback from Tampa who signed with Virginia Tech. One more guy to get through, and then we'll let you go here, Coach. And that is Joshua Nijman. Joshua Nijman. Now, he committed to Tech last year, spent a year at Fork Union. He's out of New Jersey. 6'6", 268 defensive lineman. I like this guy a lot.
I'm glad you called his name, because to me, every time I see him, it's, what's up, big fella?
I'll say their names. You coach them up.
I got it.
That's worked pretty well.
That's how I go with it on him. A big fella, because he is. When you see him, you're going to like everything about him. He's got a great smile, a great look to him every time you see him. But what you're really going to like about him is when he walks through the door, he is the pass-the-eye test guy.
He's 6'6", 268. He ran a 4.8 40 at the Nike Combine. That was in high school. Plus, he's had the prep year. He's had the postgraduate year.
He's been at Fork Union probably. That's where we really got involved with him when he was at Fork Union. But he is a guy that has just a tremendous knack for the game, understands the game, and what a tremendous skill set that he has. To have that type of size and movement ability when you're playing at that point of attack at the line of scrimmage, I mean,
defensive
we're excited
lineman?
Absolutely.
Defensive lineman. Joshua Nijman. All right, Coach, we're out of time. It's great to visit with you, Steiny. Congratulations. It looks like it's been a great haul.
It has been. Thank you so much, Bill. Appreciate everything you do.
Now, don't go away. Coming up, Scot Loeffler will join us. We're going to talk about the Hokies' newest quarterback prospect. That's when Signing Day Live continues after these messages.
Yeah, I'll let you take that.
Boy, did I hear about it. And Big Bill 7 writes, are you kidding me? No more cheeseburgers on a pizza? Are you kidding me? They're back, Big Bill, with bacon.
Are you kidding me?
Introducing the new Bacon Cheeseburger Pizza. Get a large for $12. And add our new double chocolate chip brownie for only $6 more.
Better ingredients, better pizza, Papa John's.
It's good. G&H Appliance has been proudly serving the valleys of Southwest Virginia since 1969, offering a great selection of quality brands with guaranteed savings. The knowledgeable and experienced professionals at G&H can help you find the appliance that fits your needs. G&H is a member of a nationwide buying group that will ensure savings on top products from Maytag, Whirlpool, and KitchenAid. Follow us on Facebook and Twitter. Trust someone who knows you and knows home appliances. Trust G&H Appliance. Nobody does it better.
Hokiesports.com is the official site of the Virginia Tech Hokies. Find the latest news, notes, updated rosters, and statistics for all Virginia Tech teams. Ticket information and seating charts for Lane Stadium and Castle Coliseum. With Hokies Extra, experience live streaming video of press conferences, games, and other special programming. Breaking news, inside info, and the Kroger Roth Report. Hokiesports.com, where it's always game day.
We want to remind you we've got some basketball Saturday. The Hokies in Florida State at Castle Coliseum at 3 o'clock. And then next Monday, late night with the Hokies, Georgia Tech visits Castle Coliseum. Two games in a row for Buzz Williams Hokies. The Noles and Jackets visit. Get your tickets at HokieTickets.com. Welcome back to Signing Day Live. It's great to have you with us. If you're just joining us, don't worry. We're going to have the whole show archived. You can go back and see what you've missed. But now, joining us is Virginia Tech's quarterback coach, Scot Loeffler. Good morning. How are you, sir?
Good morning, Bill. How are you?
I'm great. Tell us about how you think today has gone so far for the Hokies.
I think it's went great. There has been no surprises. We got the guys that we wanted to get. It was exciting to see the guy we're about ready to talk about. He was in at 7:01, and I was up at 5 waiting for that one. So
the guy we're talking about is Dwayne Lawson, the Virginia Tech quarterback recruit. Let's get right to it, because this is a guy that when you watch the highlights of Lawson, you're really going to be impressed. He's from Tampa, Florida, originally committed to Miami. Walk us through what happened there.
We started recruiting him, obviously, when he was a junior. We went down and watched him throw and watched him practice during spring football. He was committed to Miami, and obviously Brad Kaya started for Miami, and we were able to get in the mix because this guy wants to play at a very young age.
6'6", 207, Hillsborough High School, Tampa, Florida, one of the traditional powers in the Tampa Bay area, correct?
Absolutely. Their head coach, Coach Garcia, is a legend down there. He's very similar to Coach Beamer in terms of he's been coaching at Hillsborough for over 25 years. They're a winning program, and we thought Dwayne would fit great at Virginia Tech.
As you watch the tape, what stands out to you? You can just see how big he is. He's 6'6", but what stands out to you about the way he plays?
Well, I think he's going to be a guy that's going to eventually be 235, 240 pounds. He can make every single throw. There's some things that we need to correct with his mechanics to make him a little bit more accurate. But you can't coach his athleticism. He has the ability to make someone miss. He can get out of trouble. He's a very good athlete that has a pro quarterback potential, in my opinion.
You've got a lot of depth at quarterback now. That's a good thing to have as a quarterback coach,
yep.
Isn't it?
Yeah, we wanted to establish as much depth as we can at that position and make it extremely competitive. We want that room never to be comfortable. We obviously had Michael Brewer start last year and Motley get some time, but at the end of the day, it's always an open job. We want it to be highly competitive. We're really looking forward to Dwayne fitting into the mix here in the summertime. Just like I said, I think we're to the point where at that position we're going to be much more productive than we have been.
From a big picture standpoint, would you like to sign a quarterback every year? Does it make sense to do that?
Yeah, it does. It absolutely does. The only time you run into some trouble with that is if you do play a guy at a very young age, because all these guys want to play young right now, and that's what really happened with the Miami situation with Dwayne. He wanted to play early. He thought Miami was a great fit for him, and they played a true freshman. And this guy wants to come in and compete. I think he has the ability to come in and compete. He can make every throw. He's super athletic. He's got great football knowledge. He was coached really, really well by a guy that coached in college, was his offensive coordinator. And, we're very excited about him.
All right. So for more now on Dwayne, let's take a closer look at him. Andrew Allegretta and our veteran Hall of Fame radio network analyst Mike Burnup got together with the video and the telestrator to look at this terrific.
legitimate playing experience. I consider Motley in that same realm. He's got enough experience that you're walking into two guys that have experience, which is great. We've got two young guys, Ford and Durkin. It seems like they've been here forever, but they're still freshmen. They came in so early into this process and were able to enroll into school so early that you felt like they've been around here quite a long time. So it'll be exciting to watch those guys progress. And just like I said, as soon as we add Lawson to this mix, I think we're going to have a super, super competitive room with youth. And I think the future is going to be extremely bright at that position.
All right, maybe we'll get back to the telestrator in a bit, but let's move on to Deshaun McLeese, a gentleman that I know you guys have been very excited about. Coach, tell us about McLeese.
He's a back that has the ability to make people miss. He's got great vision. We like his speed. There was one area in our offense this year that we lacked of is throwing the football to our running backs. We think this guy has natural mitts out of the backfield. And a guy that we're really excited about. Good speed, good change of direction, good vision, tough, and he loves Virginia Tech, so we're really super happy to have him.
Deshaun committed back in July of last year. He was a first-team All-State selection in Class 6A, and he was a first-team All-Tidewater selection. One thing you know when you get a kid out of Oscar Smith High School or just about any of the big high schools down there, or any of the high schools, they always go up against really good competition. So when you see a kid pulling away from others in that league and that division, that says something, doesn't it?
Absolutely. Part of the recruiting process is evaluating what the competition of or the prospect is playing against. And obviously in the beach where he comes from, that's the best of the best in Virginia. And he's a super back.
When you see a kid that says Virginia Tech feels like home, I'm a Hokie fan, that helps in the recruiting process.
Absolutely. He's a guy from day one that that loves our school, and he's going to fit in great here.
All right, so that's Deshaun McLeese, running back out of Oscar Smith High School in Chesapeake. Next up, we talked earlier with Coach Stinespring about the offensive line prospects that Virginia Tech has signed, and this next gentleman from New Jersey is a big one and looks like he could be a really fine player for the Hokies. Tyrell Smith, 6'4", 290, again from a legendary high school program, Don Bosco Prep.
Yeah, he comes from a great high school, plays against great competition up there in northern New Jersey. I got to know Smith quite well during the recruiting process when Grimes left for LSU, so I took over that recruitment. And he's a big guy that that we think has the intelligence to possibly play center, so we're going to start him out at the center guard positions and watch him develop.
6'4", 290, that's coming in. He's going to have the opportunity to get a head start. He's one of the early enrollees.
Yes, he actually graduated from high school right around 260 pounds. He's gained 30 pounds. Doesn't look fat, but looks really put well together. And excited to watch him. We think he can move really well. We think he's got the intelligence to make all the calls at the line of scrimmage to help us at the center position. And if he can't play center, he's definitely a guard prospect.
What are the skill sets that you can look at as our fans watch this tape that make you think this guy could be a collegiate center at our level?
Well, I think he has great feet. He has the ability to move. He can climb to the next level. We love his intelligence. And with our scheme, if we can get a guy, a center, up to the next level quickly, it gives us a chance in the run game for sure.
Tyrell Smith, one of four offensive line recruits that signed with Virginia Tech today. That was clearly, judging by the results, a point of emphasis for you guys.
It was. We wanted to take as many linemen as we possibly can on both sides of the ball. We took a bunch of receivers the year prior, and obviously it's a big cycle. I can tell you right now the receiver position will be a major, major concern in the 2016 class. So, you know, it's a big cycle. We needed linemen this year, and we went out and got them.
All right, Tony Planton was a defensive lineman for the Clemson Tigers. His son is going to be an offensive lineman for the Virginia Tech Hokies. Our next prospect, DeAndre Planton. He's born in Clemson, but he played his high school ball in Norcross, Georgia. Another big, really good-looking offensive line prospect, Coach.
Big body that can move. He's going to get stronger. He's going to get, believe it or not, bigger. Whenever he walks in the door, you go, that's exactly what you're looking for. He's one of those guys that kind of right out of the high school get-go from a body structure, you go, man, he's going to be a pro football player. That's what he looks like. Super excited to watch him develop. I think Stacy Searles will do a great job developing him, and we're really, really excited to keep him. During the recruiting process, a couple SEC schools came in on him and tried to get him, and he was able to keep his commitment to Virginia Tech, and we're super happy to have him.
Overall, you guys have had the opportunity to build here from some offensive linemen, unlike maybe the receivers, like we saw last year with kids to come in and play. Fans need to know that when you're watching a guy like Planton, it'd be ideal if he could play right away. But, you know, Jonathan McLaughlin did that. But it's very rare, right, that a kid can do that?
Very rare. I've been associated with some of the best ones that were drafted in the first round. And the majority of the time, they didn't play their freshman year. They were normally redshirted. And they played that second year, and we're hoping that we can find a few guys that can come help us right off the get-go. But in all actuality, that's a tough task to do at the offensive line position.
Well, some of these kids will be here for the spring, so at least that's encouraging.
They'll get
a little bit of a head start on it. All right, before we go to the break, wrap it up. What do we want to see out of the quarterbacks here in the spring? Give us a scouting report. The spring game is going to be here before we know it.
No doubt. You look at it, we're 4 weeks essentially out from spring football. We want to basically do this. We want to protect the football better. We had way too many interceptions this year, which is Michael Brewer walked in and learned the offense in a month. We had a bunch of young receivers out there. As a group, we want to eliminate the turnovers. If we can get rid of the interceptions, I think we're going to have a heck of an opportunity to win a lot of games. We want to get rid of the missed opportunities. There's times that we had receivers open that we could have made the play. And basically getting our young receivers and our quarterbacks on the same page and being much more productive in the throw game. And I think good things are going to happen.
Lefty, congrats on getting Lawson. We're looking forward to a great spring.
Yeah, big one. I'm excited about
guy.
That one.
I know you're a happy guy. You got a guy to flip from the U to wear the orange and maroon, and that is exciting here at Virginia Tech. All right, don't go away. Signing Day Live. Much more coming up. Bud Foster, Virginia Tech's defensive coordinator, will join us here live in Blacksburg when Signing Day Live continues in a moment.
Mr. Biggles, he's safe and...
Go to your happy place, Daddy.
Happy place. Happy place.
When you bank with Union, it just feels good. You get free checking, there's no minimum balance, and no hidden fees.
I feel good.
Cute cat. Do you need help getting down?
I got this.
When you're ready to feel good about where you bank, bank at union.com.
Professional catering is the professional choice. We are the large event professionals, specializing in casual cookouts to elegant banquets from 50 to 5,000 of your closest friends. Professional catering is what we do. It's all we do.
The large event specialists at Professional Catering take great care of our team. Let them take care of your team as well.
Today, Baseball night in Blacksburg Saturday featuring Phillies World Series winning manager and Southwest Virginia native Charlie Manuel. For more information, email hartsook@vt.edu. It's Saturday night, baseball night in Blacksburg. Opening day is just a few weeks away. Welcome back to Signing Day Live here in Blacksburg. Bill Roth joined now by the Hokies defensive coordinator, Bud Foster. Everybody in the football office has an extra giddy up this morning. You guys are fired up over there.
Well, it's an exciting time. It's exciting time for obviously our program, but exciting time for these young men. And I'm really excited about this class. I like the group of kids we have on. I think we fit or have met all of our needs, and it's a good group, and can't wait to get them in here.
We've got a lot of guys to talk about. The Hokies signed 7 defensive linemen, 2 linebackers, 5 defensive backs. We've covered some of these kids as well. Overall, though, what do you like most about this group?
Well, you know, I like their athletic ability. You know, and like I said earlier, we've met all of our needs, particularly defensive line and defensive end. I do like the linebackers that we've gotten and out of this class. And then, you know, we're always going to have some defensive backs that are a priority for us. And I really like the mix of kids that we have on that back end. They're very athletic. They're long. And, you know, and it's just a good group that I'm really excited about.
We're going to get through each one of these defensive players and let Coach Foster comment on each one of them for you. We're going to start with the defensive lineman from Stonewall Jackson High School, Manassas, and that is Tim Settle, 6'3", 300 pounds, rated as the 19th overall player in the country, the number 4 defensive tackle. Coach, I know you're excited about Mr. Settle.
Yeah, Tim's a special kid. He's personality deluxe number 1, but, you know, I don't know if we've had a kid as big and as physical and as athletic as Tim, and You know he's probably a little heavier than what we just mentioned right now, but I tell you what, he's got great quickness. He's got great get off on the ball. He can flatten out and chase the ball for a big man. He's just a thick, physical guy, and I don't know if we had a guy since that has this big with this kind of feet since maybe Corey Robertson was a kid a few years ago when we were number 1 in the country defensively. But this kid possesses a lot of that great quickness off the ball, extremely physical, can play on the other side line of scrimmage, and can flatten out and make plays and push the pocket as far as rushing the passer.
Guys like that are hard to come by. I mean, there aren't that many. Well, I don't know. I don't want to put too much pressure on the kid, but there aren't that many B.J. Rodgies out there. You know?
There's not, and he's that kind of kid. You know, he's got a low center of gravity, and like I said, just tremendous twitch for a big kid. And, yeah, like I said, those guys are hard to find. You know, you kind of develop those guys at times maybe, but a guy coming in this big already, and you can see on the video, obviously, just an impact player and a hard guy to block for people to block. And I'm hoping I think that'll be the same way when he comes to our level.
What was the recruiting experience like for you and Tim Settle?
Well, you know, I was really involved with Tim being, you know, it was Torian Gray was the primary recruiter, but I was really involved with Tim, you know, me, myself recruiting Northern Virginia, spent a lot of time there. And we've got a great relationship. He called me at 7 o'clock this morning, let me know that he had signed this thing, but he's just, you know, I love his personality. Like I said, he's just personality deluxe, and he's just been a fun kid to recruit. You know, he's got a great gift to gab, very quick with it. But
we'll enjoy having him on our broadcast.
Yes, you will. We might have to tone him down a little bit, but no, he's a pleasant kid, and obviously a dynamic football player.
Welcome to the Hokie family, Tim Settle from Stonewall Jackson High School. All right, Mike Burnup and Andrew Allegretta had the opportunity to get together and take a closer look at Tim Settle from Manassas, Virginia. Let's take a look.
All right, Mike, let's take a look at Tim Settle now, a guy out of Manassas, Virginia, recruited by both Torian Gray and Charlie Wiles. Both those guys, big-time credit for a big-time defensive lineman. First off, before we take a look at the footage, the size, what do you see from him right away?
Well, the sheer size. I mean, on the hoof, the guy is huge. I mean, he's 6'3", over 300 pounds. But the thing about it is, what you want to see in a guy like that that's so big, you want to make sure he's got good feet. And he's got good hands to get rid of offensive linemen. I think he's got all those things. He's got a combination of explosiveness. He's got size. He's got athleticism. He moves laterally very well. And he's got the ability to blow up a lot of plays. I mean, the guy's a big time. He was a highly coveted recruit. And I think he's got a chance to be a really good one and make an immediate impact.
All right, so let's watch Tim Settle blow up a couple of plays. The first one, we're going to play slowly because this one he just demolishes incredibly quickly, Mike.
Well, you look at the way he gets off the ball in the snap, and he just gets great penetration quickly. And again, his sheer size just dominates and blows up the play very, very quickly. So fast into the backfield. And then he gets excited. I mean, he's a guy that plays with high energy, emotion, and again, just a terrific athlete. He moves so well for being as big as he is. Again, you can see him inside.
He's in the backfield just about all the time. As a senior, a third of his tackles, Mike, went for losses. A third of his tackles in the backfield.
Well, you can see why on some of these highlights. This is a bunch of them. I mean, he has the ability on the previous play to throw the quarterback down with one hand. And again, he gets great penetration. Nice swim move there to get around the offensive lineman and make a tackle in the backfield for loss.
You know, and he moves quickly laterally as well. He's not a guy that's going to come just right up the middle. He can track down a running back that's trying to look to get to the outside.
Yeah, no doubt about it. He's got the lateral quickness, the straight ahead downfield quickness, but just his ability to get upfield quickly and get in the backfield and make play after play, that was kind of his trademark.
Well, there's no doubt about it. Tim Settle, an impressive prospect. And one thing about him, too, Mike, is the fact that he was, according to ESPN, it is the recruiting services, and we'll see how that shakes out 2 or 3 years down the road, but the number two player in the state of Virginia. That was a concern last year, I know, for fans and obviously for the coaching staff as well. So this year, that changes, and that's nice.
Yeah, you never know about those things, those ratings and stars and whatnot. I think I read somewhere, Andrew, about the Super Bowl, that there was not one five-star recruit in the Super Bowl. So you just never know. I mean, look, as good as Cam Chancellor is a perfect example. He wasn't the most highly recruited kid, too. It was like Virginia Tech and JMU. So you never know down the road, but you like what you see on the hoof, without question.
No doubt. Tim Settle, another one that Virginia Tech adds to the 2015 crop. Bill, back to you.
All right, Andrew, thank you so much. I think everybody out there watching the Hokie Nation, they're really excited about Settle. He's a big-time player, an in-state kid. If you're excited about him, those folks out there are excited.
Oh, yeah, I really am. Like I said, I think Tim's guy has a chance to come in and be an immediate impact player. So we're excited about him coming to Virginia Tech.
All right, now when we talk about DBU and athletic tall defensive backs at the college level, that's what we're talking about here at Virginia Tech. And that is our next prospect from Independence High School in Charlotte, Adonis Alexander, 6'3". 193. Bud, fill us in on Alexander.
You know, again, Adonis is a guy that kind of reminds us a little bit of Cam. You know, like I said, he's long. He's a physical safety. He can run. And I think he's a guy that can play a lot of different things. He could probably play our free safety spot. He could play our rover position, which is what Cam really, you know, made his hay with, playing that position where he's playing right now with the Seahawks. He has the size, you know, the potential could be grow into being an athletic linebacker. So I like his versatility. I like his range. You know, he's a guy that makes plays in space. Just a really complete football player and a guy, you know, that has a lot of length and a lot of range. And just like what his future, like his upside.
You have really had to, as all defensive coordinators, adjust a lot because of offenses. You play more defensive backs, and you need more in your program than you probably did 10 years ago, right?
Yeah, there's no doubt about that. With the spread offenses and being in 3 to 4 right wide receivers all the time, having as many athletes that can play in space, but it helps to have some big guys that can have length, that can be in the throwing lanes, have an opportunity to get their hands on the ball. But and then you get a guy like this who could be a good blitzer and just do a variety of things, which I'm really excited about Adonis. You know, and he comes from a great high school program. I know he's been well coached, and we're really excited about his future.
These highlights are just awful for the offense. I mean, he's blowing up every play. I mean, for crying out loud, he's dominating.
Well, that's kind of why we were real excited about him, you know. But you see him coming off the hash here, and just has great range. He's got closing speed, and he knows how to finish the play. And that's those are the things that obviously you're looking at. You're looking at speed, quickness, the ability to make plays. But right there how he really has that closing speed. and makes a great open field tackle. I mean, sometimes it's not always going to be a big hit like wham, you know, the wham bam like Cam's talking about right now. But, you know, he's just a really complete football player that's a long athlete and really excited about his.
And you
his
get upside. Him early, too. You'll get him in the spring.
We do, yeah. You know, he came in and rolled here in January, and I was down in the weight room yesterday and, you know, really liked the way he was working and the way his body looks.
All right, let's meet Adonis Alexander. Andrew had a chance to visit with him. Let's take a look and a listen.
Bill, thanks so much. Adonis, an early enrollee here at Virginia Tech. How did that happen? How did you decide ultimately to come to Virginia Tech basically a semester early?
I already had, you know, all my credits. I started ninth grade at Northside Christian Academy. I had 8 periods a day, so I knocked out 2 of my credits for sophomore year, and I just was always ahead 2 credits, so that's how it happened.
Was it ever difficult to leave your high school early?
Not at all. Nah, it wasn't. I mean, I had friends and all, but they knew my situation. You know, they wanted the best for me, so I just made my decision to come up early.
You're ready to play football for sure. When did Virginia Tech start getting involved with you, Adonis?
It was around first semester of my junior year. I was in math class, and a student behind me told me that he's like, "You got an offer from Virginia Tech?" And I look back, I'm like, "Nah, I don't." And then I look on the Independence webpage, and they say, "Congratulations to Adonis, he got a Virginia Tech offer." And then, you know, I just asked the teacher to be excused, went to the coach's office, I talked to him, and he confirmed it.
That's fantastic. That happened really quickly for you. What did Virginia Tech say and Shane Beamer say that they liked about your game?
That was a big presence. I feel alleys well, my range. They compared me to Cam Chancellor, like, which so happened to be one of my favorite safeties. So
you grew up, in a sense, watching some of Virginia Tech, maybe not all the time, but enough to know Virginia Tech's brand.
Yeah.
All right, so I asked you this a second ago, but I know you're from Charlotte and your team's Carolina, but your guy's Cam Chancellor.
Yeah.
He just jumped the line on a field goal attempt twice and then ran back a kick. What were you thinking when you saw Cam Chancellor do that?
I mean, I was actually pulling for Carolina, but when I saw that happen, you know, of course I was happy for him, but I mean...
You no. think you could jump the line?
Oh, yeah.
So what's the most athletic thing you've ever done?
We played Butler in the first quarter. I backed up a little bit, and I just started running. As soon as I passed the line of scrimmage, they hiked the ball, and I went and tackled the kicker. Fumbled the football. We picked it up on the probably around the 12-yard line.
So basically, you did jump the line then?
Mm-hmm. Basically.
All right, Adonis, thanks so much for your time. Bill, back to you.
All right, Andrew, thanks. All right, I see how it's going to be. Now everybody's going to try to be Cam Chancellor and jump at the field goal.
Well, yeah, well, that's great, though. You know, I mean, Cam, he's really done well. We're really proud of him. But I think this youngin's got a chance, as you saw in the video. He's very rangy, can finish a play, and excited about his future.
I thought it was interesting. That had to be the most memorable math class he ever had. You find out you got a scholarship offer in the middle of math?
Well, that's pretty impressive, you know. And, well, it's another student. And I mean, what are they doing? Are they on Twitter or something like that? They must be.
Evidently.
You know, yeah, instead of paying attention to class.
All right, let's go back to Twitter for Bud Foster. You can send us questions today. Gene in Farmville. Can Tremaine Edmonds, who we're going to get to next, be the next Cam Chancellor? Similar size. Your thoughts?
You know, I don't. I think he's going the other way, where Cam was a guy that could play away from the line of scrimmage. You know, we're looking at Tremaine to be our backer. You know, fill our backer position. And, you know, he also has the body. I mean, if he follows in his dad's size, you know, he could end up moving down to a defensive end. That's not – we've talked about that. But that's – right now, I'm plugging him in at the backer position. And he's a guy that can be downhill and can be in throwing lanes, can be a good blitzer. You know, we're getting into a lot of bear package, which now walks our backer up, being an edge guy anyway. And I think those are – you know, those position – you know – is a perfect fit for what his body's going to and where what we want him to do. So this is a really dynamic young kid, and I think this is one of the 26 sets of brothers we've had here coming here now, maybe 27 with counting him. But I'm really excited about Tremaine and his future, and just a long athletic kid, and comes from a great family.
Yeah, we talk about the Virginia Tech families, whether it's the Grimms or the Fullers. The Edmonds are in that group now as well. Let's take a closer look at Tremaine. Maine, 6'4", 220, Danville, Virginia. You can see on the videotape, he is a tremendous, tremendous athlete.
Yeah, without a doubt. I mean, here's a guy, you know, taking the snap at quarterback, and that's what I like about it. You see his speed. You're going to see his ability to blitz. You're going to see his ability to make finish plays, make plays in space. And, you know, I haven't had as tall a linebacker probably since Jay Cousride or Ben Taylor. And but you can see there, you know, he's got great acceleration. He knows how to finish a play. He got his head across the bow and ran through. But I just think the kid, you know, with what we like to do, the pressure we like to bring with our linebackers, you know, I don't know if I've had a guy maybe as athletic looking since maybe Xavier Deeby, which is really encouraging for me and our defense. So we can do a lot of things and a lot of, you know, I think he brings a lot of versatility to our backer position, not only just stopping the run, but being a guy in the passing game, you know, whether it be in coverage or you know, in a blitz mentality.
Linebacker Tremaine Edmonds, the third Edmonds brother to commit to Virginia Tech. Welcome to the Hokie family, young man, and it's great to see another Edmonds. You know, Dad was a Pro Bowler, for crying out loud.
Exactly.
And the brothers have been great here, so it's fantastic.
Well, and Mother Cookie
follows in.
And Mother Cookie was a, you know, big time track athlete, so good bloodline, and you know, we're excited about Tremaine coming on board.
Hey, I want you to fill us in on Darius Fullwood, defensive end, 6'4", 240. He's from Our Lady of Good Counsel High School, up near the University of Maryland, and only Maryland.
Yeah, I tell you, another kid from a great program, and again, he's a guy that fills a need for us at our defensive end spot. You know, there he moves down inside, and it's kind of what we do with our scheme. We may stem and put our defensive end sometimes over an offensive guard. He's a guy that has great get off, can create mismatches, can penetrate the line of scrimmage, can bend his body, has a good edge rush, can flip his hips. Those are all the things that we really like about, you know, what Darius, you know, what his abilities bring to the table. And really excited about this kid. Comes, like I said, a great program, has been well coached, has a lot of ability, you know, and we're excited about his future as well.
6'4", 240. Keep an eye on Darius Fullwood when he arrives here at Virginia Tech. All right, another defensive end, this one from Rocky Mount, North Carolina. Hope I'm saying this right. Hushun Gaines?
Yes.
6'4", 220 as well. Let's take a look at Gaines. He's from Rocky Mount, North Carolina.
Yeah, another young man that has length, you know, can bend his body. The kind of the body type that we like, you know. He's got quick twitch. He can get off the football. He can redirect. He can bend, which, you know, that means he's not a stiff guy. You know, he's not segmented. Very athletic, and you know, with what we do with our ends, you know, not only do they rush the passer, but we'll drop them in the flat. We'll drop them down the seam. They may take a back out of the backfield. They may be responsible for the pitch, as he was there. You know, he can do a lot of things and is very versatile and is very athletic. And I really think this kid is an outstanding prospect. He's going to be a heck of a football player for us.
Gaines, defensive end. He said one of the reasons he picked Virginia Tech was the food. You know, Tech's dining facility was rated number one again by Forbes magazine. That's good, right?
That is good. And those guys, they tested that. I saw it firsthand.
Is that right?
Yes.
So you go over to West End, it's a recruiting trip.
Oh, yeah. And I tried to stay away, but you always got to dabble in a little bit.
What's your favorite thing over there? London broil?
It is.
Isn't that amazing?
It is. Well, those guys, Mel, they were eating a lot of lobster and a lot of shrimp, and besides, you know, dabbling in the steaks and things.
Once again this year, Virginia Tech, number one dining facility in all of college athletics, and in fact, the entire nation as well. Don't go away. Bud and I are going to continue running through our defensive signees when Signing Day Live continues after these messages.
Great meal starts with a great sandwich on the new Simple 6 menu. Six of our best 6-inch subs, now in made just for you meals for just $6 each every day.
I got it made fresh at Subway.
Take your pick from six of our best subs, like the tender turkey breast, the Italian BMT, sweet onion chicken teriyaki, and more. With any bag of chips and a 21-ounce drink, all six are just $6 every day on the new Simple 6 menu.
I got it made fresh at Subway.
Our first big sale of the year is here during the winter sales event on the Sheeler Motor Mile. The incredible success of the tax sale last month has us busting at the seams with quality trade-ins.
We're over.
overstocked.
Choose from over 1,000 pre-owned vehicles on the lot now in one location and ready to move. Volume selling means volume pricing.
Vehicles starting at $36.50.
And because Sheeler owns the finance company, we say yes. Get your new wheels for the new year during the winter sales event on the Sheeler Motor Mile or 24/7 at Sheeler.com.
When you're looking to invest in a hardwood floor, you do all the right things, and so do we. We go straight to the mill, so you get the highest quality flooring at the lowest possible price. We offer great brands like Bellawood, which is backed by a transferable 100-year warranty. Over 2 million families have come to trust our flooring and the hardwood experts who help them realize their dream. Let us help with yours. Lumber Liquidators. Hardwood floors for less.
Start jumping, Hokies. Virginia Tech basketball hosts ACC rivals Florida State and Georgia Tech. Be there when the Noles and Yellow Jackets visit Castle Coliseum Saturday, February 7th and Monday, February 9th. Don't miss any of the action. See it live. Secure your seats for these big-time ACC games at HokieTickets.com.
Signing Day Live continues. Remember, student season tickets go on sale on March 19th for Virginia Tech football. All six home games, including the historic Monday night football game against the defending national champs, for just $81. Student season tickets go on sale on March 19th. I don't know about you. I'm already looking forward. You got spring football. It's only recruiting signing day, but I'm looking forward to the season already.
Well, yeah, we've got a lot of growing up.
A lot to do, right?
Yeah, but I'm excited about that opening day. And I tell you what, we've got a talented football team. And, you know, we were probably a few plays away from, you know, winning 10 football games ourselves. You know, we had, I think it was about 11 guys that didn't dress for that game in the bowl game that we beat Cincinnati in that played and had a significant role in the, in the win over Ohio State. So there's a fine line, and I we were a few plays away from having a great season, but I'm excited about, you know, getting this group back together. You know, we'll have majority of the defense back, and there's nothing like experience, so I'm looking forward to it.
All right, we're going to continue talking about our recruits. Remember, coming up in the next hour, Barton Simmons, the national recruiting analyst for 247 Sports, will be here. We're glowing about all of our kids. We think this is a great class. We're going to get some objective take as well from a national analyst coming up in a few minutes, so don't go away. Let's continue rolling through our recruits, though. Carson Light, an outside linebacker. Tarpon Springs, Florida, another linebacker and another Florida recruit. Coach, fill us in.
Yeah, you know, Torian, has that area, but I went down to see Carson several times, and just like what he's all about. This kid has a lot of size. He measured in at 6'2", 242. You know, he's an early enrollee, big physical kid that can run, has a great football IQ. Like his toughness, I think he's a guy that, you know, is going to play. He plays extremely hard, will make people around him better. I think, you know, we're probably going to work him as our Mike backer position. He's a guy that can run from inside, outside, play from sideline to sideline. We need to create some depth there, but, you know, I think he's a guy that will compete for starting position at that spot. And just really a good football player, like I said, is big, is physical, has the ability to blitz and pressure. You can see right there he can make plays in space, and he's playing against good people, down there in Florida. And that's one thing you look for. You look for kids at linebacking position that can go out and make plays in space. You can see he has the ability to run. And I like what he's all about. Like I said, I think there's one thing I like about Carson. Football is very important to him, and he takes it very seriously. But he excels at it as well.
There was a play.
I tell you, I think he blocked. I think he blocked six or seven punts this year, and
he had two defensive scores as well.
Yeah, and then they brought him in on short yards and goal line situations to run the football. So really a complete football player. Very tough football player, very physical football player, and then a guy that has a great football IQ. So I'm really excited about his future.
Played his first 2 years of high school football in Raleigh at Cardinal Gibbons High School, and then his family moved down to the St. Petersburg area. He was named the Pinellas County Player of the Year down there in St. Pete. He's an early enrollee, and he had a chance to visit with Andrew Allegretta. Let's meet this young Hokie.
All right, Bill, thanks so much. Carson, thank you for talking with us. What is it about Coach Foster and his defensive system that makes you want to play here at Virginia Tech?
Everything about it. I mean, he just cares so much for his players, and
especially his linebackers, because he's the inside linebackers coach and he wants them to thrive, and he's built the defense around them for everybody else to be put into positions to make them make plays. And I want to be a part of that and to be the leader of the team and just be part of that system.
Does he have a sense of where eventually you might end up along the backer position, the mic position, whatever it is?
Right now he's saying that I could be an athletic mic for him because I can move. I've got good size. He could put me in the middle. But if he needs me to put me out at backer, he says he could do that too.
When did Virginia Tech first start recruiting you?
About a year ago in December. Coach Beamer, Coach Moorhead, and Coach Greg all came down to my school on a Saturday and called my buddy George Campbell and I in. And our coach had us come in, and we talked to them for about an hour. And after that, they said to come up and visit. And about a month later, I did. Came up, I visited, met with Coach Foster. Within 5 minutes, he gave me my offer.
For you, I know Virginia Tech was kind of the first among the bigger schools to offer you. What was it like to have those three people come down and pull you aside on a weekend and want to talk to you?
It was pretty cool. Just having them take that kind of interest in me, mostly because I didn't know much about Tech or a lot of other programs, just because I always focused on my game and not the next level. I was always focusing on what I can do right now to make myself better for the next level. So I thought it was really cool and a good experience for them to all show that kind of interest in me.
Most recently you were in Florida, but you're kind of a Raleigh guy. I mean, you said you didn't know much Tech. Did you know anything about Virginia Tech before they started talking to you?
Nope, I didn't know a thing about them. Completely new to them. Once I started hearing about them through recruitment, I kind of said, oh, they're a good defensive program, small college, that sounds nice to me. It's what I was looking for in a program, and then they came and visited, and things kind of went my way.
I like how you just called a student body of about 33,000 people a small college. It does have that kind of feel, though, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. I mean, compared to UCF and ASU, it is a very small school. It does feel like it's a very small campus just because, like, I can walk 10 minutes and I'll be in downtown Blacksburg. I'll walk 10 more minutes and I'll be at the other side of the drill field, and it's just all so close. It just feels small.
Carson, thank you so much for your time. Mm-hmm. Bill, back to you.
All right, what a terrific prospect. Glad he's here.
Yeah, I am. Like I said, it's important to him. You can see that. And very tough-minded kid. And he's going to make people around him better. So I'm really excited about his future.
All right, we're here with Bud Foster. But joining us now live on the telephone is Barton Simmons. He is the National Recruiting Analyst for 247. This is the third year of this program, as you know. We'd always like to try to get an outsider's perspective on the Hokies' take. So, Barton, good afternoon to you. Thank you, sir, for joining us. How are you on the busiest day of the year for you as well?
I'm doing great. I'm riding high. This has been fun, but, appreciate you having me on.
Tell me, in your expert opinion, the strengths of Virginia Tech's 2015 recruiting haul.
Well, I think when I look at this class, the thing that really jumps out to me is the defensive line. And I mean, Virginia Tech has always been known for great defensive line. It's another outstanding group. You know, Yatsula Needman, the kid out of prep school that's already on campus over there, is a kid that I'm just thrilled to see what he can do. I mean, he's 6'6 plus. He's so athletic at that size. I think he's, a little raw, but with that staff, get their hands on him. That kid's got a chance to be really special. Tim Settle's the guy that the Virginia Tech beat just about everybody in the country to land. Huge interior kid that can just sort of take up space and get blockers away from those second-level players. And then I think the guy that maybe is the sleeper of this defensive line group that really has me excited is Eric Whitehead out of Indianapolis. Not the biggest kid. He's a little bit squatty, but, man, he is so physical, plays with such a motor, just fun to watch. And I just think he's part of, what looks like a really loaded group on that defensive front.
We're joined by Barton Simmons, the scouting director for 247 Sports. Barton, let me ask you this. What was the national perspective when Lawson flipped his commitment from the University of Miami to Virginia Tech at quarterback?
Well, I think that was a huge steal. I mean, and Dwayne Lawson is a kid that everybody in the state of Florida that's seen him throw, that's seen him in person, everyone's bullish on this guy. Everyone thinks he's got a chance to be really special. So this wasn't some kid from Florida that was just kind of sneaking out of the state because nobody else wanted him. This was a kid that was, if anything, becoming more and more of a high-priority kid for everybody around the country. So, for a guy that size with that kind of an arm talent, to head to Blacksburg, I think is a huge pickup, and I really think that's the type of talent at the quarterback position that you can really build around. It's probably one of the real signature gifts of this recruiting cycle for the Hokies.
Bart, let me ask you this. Fans are out there watching. How do you determine what makes a young man a three-star or a four-star or a five-star recruit?
Well, it's just all about information and trying to get as much of it as possible, seeing these kids in as many steps as possible, and getting a feel for just what their upside and potential is. We really base our rating on the NFL. A five-star guy is a potential first-round draft pick. A four-star is a potential NFL player. And three stars are still, I think the misconception is the three stars aren't good players. We think three stars can be great football players in college. And I think that, you know, Virginia Tech, as well as anybody, has proven what you could do with a three-star guy that, you know, with the right skill set that fits the system. I mean, those guys really develop players well. And that's why I think with the right staff in place, it's all about, you know, not the ratings, but just about the, you know, the individual players and what they bring to the table.
All right, final question for you. When you look at the ACC, where did Virginia Tech's 2015 recruiting class fit in the league, and how would you rank the top of our conference?
Yeah, I mean, in the ACC, Virginia Tech is sitting right now at number four. As signing day continues to kind of come to a close, it looks like they're going to hang out right around in that sort of upper echelon of the conference, and so I think it's a great effort to continue to, you know, be one of the leaders in that conference. That's a 14-team conference, and they're right up there with the best. And so I think it was, you know, end of the day on signing day, going to be a really strong a year for Virginia Tech. And frankly, they're just a point behind you know, the number three team. So it could be number three by the end of the day. It's just that good of a class.
Fans can read more about your recruiting analysis nationally. Who's number one in the nation? I'm just curious. Who'd you rank number one today?
Alabama is hanging on to number one right now. Assuming everything goes well, they should hang on to it. But USC, with some of their big hits here late in the game, should challenge as well. So it should be a fun, suspenseful close if you're into that sort of thing.
Barton, thanks for joining us this afternoon. We really appreciate your time on the busiest day of the year for you. You know, it's interesting. I think a lot of folks follow recruiting almost as much as they follow the games.
Well, there's no doubt about that. It's amazing all the information we get from different people sending us emails and whatnot of who we should look at and what we should be doing. So, and that's an exciting, with all the you know, the media and all the new shows and all the different things that are you know, are highlighting recruiting. It's making a lot more people aware of what's going on out there.
All right, let's get to some more of our defensive prospects here at Virginia Tech. Let's turn our focus now to Dwayne Johnson, cornerback, 6'1", 160. He's from Woodson High School in Washington.
Yeah, another kid that you know, we really like. We've had a tie-in with this program, you know, high school, and but a kid that has great length. He's a little heavier right now than what that 160, but he, as you can see, he's very fluid. Has great range. He has great hips. Has outstanding ball skills, you know, is a guy that we feel like has a chance to, you know, kind of fit in what we've been doing, you know, being a longer kid. Kind of reminds me of a young Kyle Fuller. Now, I'm not saying that's where he's going to end up, but, you know, he's a guy that has that kind of body type, a long kid that, you know, is a tough-minded kid, is a willing tackler, but, again, has great range and, you know, outstanding ball skills and, you know, and the way the receivers, is they're getting taller and taller, that, you know, you can, the longer you can have as a cornerback and a defensive back, that helps you down the road to be able to defend some of these taller players.
Dwayne Johnson, cornerback, the newest Virginia Tech Hokie. His brother plays receiver at Florida Atlantic. It's a heck of a family to have two sons both getting Division I football offers. Next up on our list, another cornerback, and he's a guy that I think Tech fans are going to have an awful lot of fun watching. You're going to have an awful lot of fun coaching, from Greensboro, Mook Reynolds.
Yeah, another one that, you know, he's a tall kid at 6 foot being as a corner. But has a lot of abilities. Like what he's all about. We've actually kind of, you know, pushed Mook as a guy we did with Kendall Fuller, as far as a guy that can come in and be an immediate impact guy, could potentially be a nickel guy or a dime guy, as we played against, as we did against University of Cincinnati in the bowl game. But it's very versatile. Can play corner, as you can see here. Played a little bit of safety. Can run the alley. can make plays, is a good tackler, good finisher. You know, you like that, you know, besides having the ability to cover and flip your hips and things, you also like to have those guys, particularly our boundary corner. That's kind of been our playmaking spot and one of our better football players on our team. I think that's where we kind of project Mook being, is that boundary corner that can not only cover, but can also be an outstanding tackler and be involved in the run game as well. So I really think just a complete football player that has the versatility to play, you know, any of those positions on the back end.
Steiny said he's also been your assistant recruiting coordinator.
Well, I tell you, he does a great job. I mean, today with the social media, he's a guy that's on that all the time and recruiting guys and, you know, bowl games or the bowl games for these the high school players.
Guys, yeah.
I mean, he's hitting them all the time. And that's what you want. The good players want to be surrounded by other good players. And he identifies that. I'll tell you another one, Tim Settles, the same way. But those two kids have, and this one in particular, Mook has personality deluxe. I like what he's all about.
All right, let's meet Mook Reynolds, the newest Hokie. He had a chance to visit with Andrew. Guys?
All right, Bill, thanks so much. Mook, when did Virginia Tech start recruiting you, and why did you decide that Virginia Tech was ultimately the place for you?
Tech started recruiting me November of my junior year. I took a visit in February, came up. That was the first visit I ever took to a university outside of Carolina in-state schools. I just felt Tech was the most genuine. I felt to further my career, this would be the best place for me academically and athletically. I took insight, talked to every coach, talked to, you know, past players, talked to present players. All in all, weighed out the options with my family. And at an early moment in my high school career, I felt this was the best place for me.
You had mentioned that your older brother always had thought about Virginia Tech. What did you know about Virginia Tech before you decided to sign on and started getting recruiting?
I knew within this program, defense is what really lifts this program to success. That's really what stood out to me. I wanted to be a part of something special where defense wins or loses the games for you. So, with weighing in the options of, you know, defensive schools, Tech was really the best place for me. My brother, you know, he's a football guru, very smart guy when it comes to football, knows his stuff. So, listening to him, listening to the advice he gave me, with him and my dad, you know, like I said, it was the best place for me.
What names were you watching when you were watching Virginia Tech in Greensboro? Are we talking about Kyle Fuller, Jaron Hosley? What names?
I've been compared to Kyle Fuller as far as Coach Wise, Coach Gray, and Coach Foster. At the early part when they recruited me, watching my film instantaneously, they thought I reminded them of Kyle Fuller. So, you know, as opposed to that and seeing how much success he had in this program, and I come in, do the same thing, learn from his game, watch his film, add my own twist in there. Best place for me, that's all I can say.
I hope it works out like that. Now, you did, again, commit early to Virginia Tech, and it sounds like once you did, you started recruiting for Virginia Tech as well. How did that start happening?
When you commit to a school, you want a lot of guys at your talent caliber to come in with you. Coach Wiles, Coach Greg, Coach Foster would tell me, these guys, we need this guy, we really want to get this guy, and I wanted to make sure that my class could be a, you know, memorable class to come into Tech. So, you know, I just hopped on those guys, did the best I could do, like I was a recruiter, because I am. I mean, I'm trying to get people to come in with me. So I recruited about five or six guys. Pretty much all of them committed, so must be pretty good.
Yeah, I'm sure the coaches appreciate that, Mook. Thank you. We appreciate you. Bill, back to you.
All right, Andrew, thanks. Articulate young guy, isn't he?
Yes, he is. And like I said, you know, he could end up being a safety force. I don't know. But he's a guy that will take control back there and be a leader for us down the road. And I'm really excited about what Mook will bring, to Virginia Tech.
All right, let's go to Indiana to talk about the next two recruits, starting with Eric Whitehead, defensive lineman from Indianapolis, 6'1", 300-pounder. Coach, fill us in on Eric Whitehead.
Well, you know, Steve Tutsey, the guy that, coached a couple guys that have come through our way, from Indianapolis, recommended this kid for us to come by and see him. And Aaron Moorhead was on our staff at the time, but Steve's a high school coach and, recommended Eric, and we got a chance to take a look at him. And again, just a physical kid, kind of is in the mold of some of the tackles that we've had in the past. You know, he's only about a 6'1" guy. but he is a 300-pounder. He's got great quickness, can bend, can redirect, you know, can push the pocket, but also, you know, can flatten out and make a play. But I really like how he plays the game. You know, he, like right there, you know, the guy is on the ground for a second, you know, and pops right up and makes a play. But very physical, very athletic for a big kid, plays extremely hard for a 300-pounder. You know, you like to see him chasing the ball from sideline to sideline, plays extremely hard. And he's kind of fits that mold of guys that we've had in the past. The Derek Hopkins, the Antoine Hopkins, those kind of guys that are not your 6'3", 6'4" guy, but a 6 foot, 6'1", 300-pound squatty body is, the analyst said, but really good football player.
One of seven defensive linemen that the Hokies signed today from the same high school, also from the same defense, is Adonis Williamson, 6'1", 190. He played on the same team with Whitehead.
Yeah, again, Adonis is another guy, another corner, a very versatile guy that can play a lot of different positions. You know, he's a 6'1 kid, very physical, has a lot of range, has great hips, has good ball skills, can do a lot of different things. And, you know, it's kind of been our mentality a little bit, is trying to find taller, athletic guys that can be very versatile. As we were talking, you know, you want to get as many of those kids on the field as you possibly can because of the style of offense that people are playing nowadays. But he's a kid that can play corner and obviously could play any of our safety positions and potentially be a whip or nickel type guy. And as you can see, very physical. He knows how to finish, can run the lane. You see a lot of position or play from here from a safety position. But, you know, we'll start a lot of these guys out at corner to see their skill set at this level. You know, it's a little bit different. Obviously, the game's much faster at the major college level. Coming even, this is an outstanding high school, big high school in Indianapolis, and probably the best football in the state. But it's just the speed of the game is so much more different at this level. But we'll always look at guys first as a corner, and then we can always move. But you see right in that particular clip, great hips, the ability to get into the receiver and go play the ball.
All right, but wrap it up for us. You have seven defensive linemen, five DBs, two linebackers, at least on paper today. If you could summarize that group of 14 young men, what would it be?
Well, like I said, I think we fit our needs. We needed some defensive ends. We feel like we can, if we win up front, we'll give ourselves a chance. I feel like our back end, we've really recruited some very talented kids, some long kids that have ability. And then I really do like the two linebackers that we have in our program, right now. So I think it's a complete group. We fit all of our needs, but it's a very athletic group and a long group in a lot of areas. So I'm really excited about them.
All right, two things before you go. Number one, congratulations again on the contract extension.
Well, I'm
really
excited.
So happy.
Well, I'm excited. I saw Whit come in here. I really appreciate him and Dr. Sands, and they're being proactive in keeping me here. And this is, I've been here. This is beginning year 29.
It's, yes,
doesn't happen in this day and age. But I'm really excited to be here.
And finally, real quick, spring football teaser for the defense. What do you want to see most?
Well, I want to see us continue to grow and be hungry and keep that attitude and start how we finish the season.
That's Bud Foster. Now, don't go away. We've got the big finish of today's show coming up. Don't go away.
When we stopped selling the cheeseburger pizza, boy, did I hear about it. At Big Bill 7 writes, "Are you kidding me? No more cheeseburgers on a pizza? Are you kidding me?" They're back, Big Bill, with bacon.
Are you kidding me?
Introducing the new Bacon Cheeseburger Pizza. Get a large for $12 and add our new double chocolate chip brownie for only $6 more.
Better ingredients, better pizza, Papa John's.
It's good.
And Telos helps every member of the family get a smartphone and the freedom to actually use it. It's 2 gigs of data with unlimited talk and text for only $25 a month. And zero down on all smartphones. Get the phones you want and save money every month. We'll even buy out your contract. And Telos, wireless for the people.
Gunderman Group.
Gunderman Group is growing.
Getting in a groove.
Growth is gratifying.
Goal is to grow.
Gotta get greater growth.
I just talked to UPS. They've got expert advice, special discounts, new technologies, like smart pickups. They'll only show up when you print a label, and it's automatic. We save time and money.
Time?
Money?
Time and money.
Awesome.
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 I love logistics.
Coming to Bristol Motor Speedway in 2016 is a college football showcase unlike anything the world has seen before. Fans from Virginia Tech and Tennessee have lobbied for years for the two schools to play at the world's fastest half mile. It will be the biggest college football game ever. That wait is finally over.
Virginia Tech home football begins on Labor Day Monday night. The defending national champion Ohio State Buckeyes visit Lane Stadium. Monday night football, Hokies and Buckeyes. Don't need to have a whole lot say more than that, do we? Wow, it's going to be an exciting opening week and an exciting opening night in the ACC and for the Hokies. If you're just joining us, welcome back to our Signing Day Live program. Now, if you're joining us late, that's okay. The show will be archived on HokiesSports.com and Hokies Extra as well, so you'll have a chance to go back and scroll through it and hear what Coach Loeffler and Coach Stinespring and Coach Foster had to say as well. So a lot coming up. Now, one of the real exciting things that our coaches have talked about to our recruits, not only the class of 2015 that you've met today, but the 2016 recruits, we're already working on that class as well, is Virginia Tech's brand new indoor football facility. If you've been in Blacksburg during the past few months or so, you've seen it rise into the sky. It almost looks as big, in fact, maybe even bigger than Castle Coliseum. Hannah Martin has the latest for us on the beautiful new indoor football facility that will open this fall here in Blacksburg.
You see a lot of big barns, if you will, and it is a big barn, but it's a beautiful big barn, and it's going to be very nice.
And this beautiful big barn is right on schedule. A state-of-the-art facility, picturesque and versatile, is set to open in July. Wired well enough to capture every moment on video, lit well enough for late-night practice, and spacious enough to kick in.
It's 85 feet tall, which is bigger than most. Coach Beamer wanted to be able to punt in there with ease, and the 85 feet allows us to do that. Most of the facilities that you see are 65 to 75 feet tall. It cost a little extra to go a little higher, but for what we wanted to use it for, it was worth the expense.
Up here at the top of the north end zone, it's obvious that this building is plenty tall enough to punt in, and finishing the exterior is the focus of these workers right now. But the last major decision that needs to be made deals with the creative elements on the inside of the building.
The last big one left is, how are we going to graphically represent Virginia Tech Athletics inside the building? Putting out an RFP now, a request for proposal now. We expect to have, we've selected 8 or 10 of the very best in the country to certainly see it. We're looking forward to what they come up with.
About 75% of the graphics will be football, 25% for the other sports that will use the facility, like soccer, lacrosse, and baseball. And not only is this facility great for all these sports, but Gabbard says it will be great for all of Hokie Nation.
The one thing that the fans will really enjoy is the way it's positioned in the close proximity to the game field itself. The night vision that you're going to see of this facility lit up at night during a night football game will be very dramatic.
And this facility will be as good, if not better, than any other, college or pro. Picturesque, exceptionally versatile, and coming soon. For Signing Day Live, I'm Hannah Martin.
All right, Hannah, thanks. That's going to be a spectacular facility when it opens this fall for Virginia Tech football. All right, now we've talked about how exciting Signing Day Live is for us, for our coaches, and for Virginia Tech fans, but what is it like for the players? Well, we are fortunate at Tech to have three guys who signed and played at Virginia Tech and now are back here working at Virginia Tech. Coach Torian Gray, star tailback Kevin Jones, and outstanding offensive lineman Keith Short. They're standing by with Andrew. Fellas, good morning. Or good afternoon to
you
all.
Thank you very much. We appreciate it. Excited to talk with these guys. Let them relive their signing day memories, as we were talking about beforehand. A little bit different from this side of the camera shot to the other side of the camera shot. But we'll get into that. Of course, Keith Short, class of 1995, signed.
Correct.
92 and 2001 for Kevin Jones. Kevin, let's start with you.
All right.
You had the most behind your signing day, the biggest, I would suppose, of the collection right here. What do you remember from that day? Why was it a special day for you?
It was a special day because it was something that I dreamed of since I was about, you know, 8 years old. Wanted to get to the pros, but definitely Virginia Tech was the springboard for that for me. And so just wanting to get here and just figure out where my career was going to start after high school, it was just the biggest day of my life.
For you, are you okay with the sense? Let me ask you this question, because yours was big. You came down to Penn State and Virginia Tech, number one high school recruit out of Pennsylvania. Yours was big. A lot of guys have almost followed your model. You've started something. Are you okay with that idea that Kevin Jones has been the guy that's kind of launched what has been such an important day for so many people with the way that they announced their signing?
Wow, I didn't know anybody really recognized that, because I was thinking about that not too long ago, you know, with that, you know, how people choose hats and stuff like that, and I wound up choosing a jersey. But yeah, I'm okay with it. To me, it's you can have fun with the decision that you're making. So that's what I was able to do, have fun. My family was there, a bunch of supporters, and it was just a great time in all of our lives.
Torian, as much fanfare for you as it was for Kevin Jones?
Not quite. On signing day for me, I had already made my decision. I committed to Virginia Tech, and my decision basically came down to, was I going to leave Florida and go to a colder climate in Virginia Tech, or was I going to go to a much colder climate at Kansas or Kansas State? And that really factored down to me. I didn't have as many school or options as, yeah, say, Kevin had or whatnot. And but obviously it was a decision that's come full circle and been great for me.
Keith, what do you remember about your day?
The biggest part for me was very little fanfare. I had two offers, Virginia Military Institute and Virginia Tech. So I'd made up my mind months in advance, and I was worried about the fax going through. Actually, I didn't even know what a fax was at the time. This was pre-internet days. So actually, I signed it. I took it into my high school, gave it to one of the people that works in the offices, and they faxed it in, and that was it. No press release or anything.
I will say, with all this, it's been probably the best decision that we've all made. Obviously, we're back here working at the university, and Virginia Tech is taking care of us just like we decided to come here. So it's been a back and forth relationship since we signed here. So I think it's a positive thing, and it talks a lot about the university and about what we believe in here.
Yeah, there's a lot of things that's really important about Virginia Tech. One thing that I wanted to ask you, Keith, was like a lot of guys that will probably go through this over the next couple of months or years or so, is you switched positions.
Right.
You were a tight end, you were a defensive lineman. Eventually you became a starting and all Big East offensive lineman. What was that like for you? Was that a difficult process?
When they first told me, I came in as a defensive end. I thought I would play tight end. I didn't have enough talent to play either position, so I knew the next stop, it was either offensive line, or I was just going to be on scout team for the rest of my career. So I was nervous about the switch. I didn't want to do it at first, but after I moved, I realized it was the only, you know, option, the only way that I would ever play here was to move the offensive line. So I embraced it towards the end, and I'm glad that I made the switch.
How about you, Torian? You committed here. I got a sense of why the decision was what the decision was for you, but 1992, Virginia Tech was still a program on the rise at that point. It wasn't something that Kevin committed to in 2001,
right,
coming off the national championship. Why take that risk?
Well, quite honestly, it came down to I felt I can come to Virginia Tech and play earlier. Like I said, it was warmer than the Kansas schools that was recruiting me, but it came down to I knew I wanted to go to the NFL, and, you know, Florida State was recruiting me, but they hadn't offered me, wanted to bring me up on a visit. But I honestly felt that I could probably come here and succeed, get on the field early, and, you know, right or wrong with my decision, it ended up working out great for me. I started 3.5 years and got drafted second round. So, you know, when I look back on it, I can say I made the right decision.
I think we should restart the whole signing day process for these two. I think they got shortchanged. Maybe do something bigger and better for these guys. Get something what Kevin Jones said. We appreciate you guys, Keith, Torrey, and Kevin, talking with us here on signing day. Let's continue with a look at Virginia Tech's Hokies in the pros. Fantastic Tech players out there playing right now in the NFL. Here they are.
It was another great year for a handful of former Hokies playing in the NFL.
Cam Chancellor has been a key to Seattle's vaunted defense, and this year had 94 tackles, 2 interceptions, and received Pro Bowl honors. Cam wasn't the only former Hokie to have a big-time year. Here are some of the others. In Houston, offensive tackle Dwayne Brown anchored a line that was 5th in the NFL in running the ball. Brown's performance this year was good enough to earn him his 3rd career Pro Bowl selection. In Chicago, rookie Kyle Fuller was thrust into the starting lineup for the Bears because of injury. Despite the lack of experience, Kyle stepped up and tallied 82 tackles, 4 interceptions, and 3 forced fumbles. Kyle's brother, Corey Fuller, also had a solid year playing for Detroit. Corey had 14 catches, 11 for first downs, and 1 touchdown. Also for the Lions, defensive lineman Daryl Tapp played every game, had 17 tackles, and recovered a fumble. Eddie Royal caught 62 passes for San Diego. He had 778 yards and 7 touchdowns. Also for the Chargers, cornerback Brandon Flowers had 52 tackles and 3 interceptions. Pittsburgh linebacker Jason Worlds had 62 tackles, an interception, and a forced fumble. Jason was a quarterback's nightmare, leading the Steelers with 7.5 sacks this year. Saints kicker Shane Graham went 19 for 22 on field goals, and he was perfect inside 40 yards. Will Montgomery started 8 games at center for the Denver Broncos and played in all 16. And how about Logan Thomas? His first career completion was an 81-yard touchdown pass against the Broncos. And that's a look at Hokies in the NFL this year. For Signing Day Live, I'm Hannah Martin.
All right, Hannah, thanks so much. Hannah's a great product of our student broadcaster program here at Virginia Tech. We appreciate her being with us today for Signing Day Live. And joining me now on our set is the Hokies Director of Athletics, Whit Babcock. This is an exciting day for all of us. How about from the AD's perspective?
Oh, yeah. We love it, too. It's an exciting day. Everybody's undefeated today. And to watch this staff come together and put together a great class, we're obviously really excited about it. And, you know, usually as the AD, you pay a little more attention after they're signed and they're here and up and running. But I have to admit, I've been taking a sneak peek at it and following it fairly closely, and great day for the Hokies.
You've had the opportunity to meet some of these student-athletes on their recruiting trips. Yes. As well. If you're a high school senior and you come in and you meet with the athletics director, what kind of things do you share with a prospective student-athlete?
Yeah, that's a great question. Our coaches, I say to them, I say, hey, if I can help, I'm available and I'll do it, or if you feel like it's not needed, that's fine. So I don't demand it. But whenever they ask, whatever the sport may be, I'm happy to do it, and I like to do it. And, you know, you're talking to parents or guardians and the prospective student athlete, but we're allowed to recruit on campus, and I do my best sales pitch about where we're headed and why it's exciting to be a Hokie. And so, yeah, I do my part. And we encourage our whole athletic department to do their part. The way if they're walking down the hallway and they see recruits or prospective student athletes in town for any sport, the way we greet them, the way our facilities look, I mean, recruiting is the lifeblood of every sport in our athletic department.
Was there any question where you were going to play your college baseball? Did you line a bunch of baseball caps up?
No,
wasn't up for that.
I wasn't that good. so maybe I'm living a little vicariously through these guys. But there wasn't a lot of coverage of where I was going to school, that's for sure.
A couple of things I'd like to touch on. Number one, the cost of attendance that the ACC and Power 5 schools have agreed to do. And how will that affect Virginia Tech and the big announcement that the department made last week and your commitment to all athletes here at Tech?
Yeah, really, we came out with our program. As you know, it's called the Pylons of Promise, and it really serves two purposes. One is to say, hey, we're committed. There's change in our industry in the NCAA, but we're going to embrace it and go with it and compete with the best. And so here's our commitment there. And then the promise aspect is just a very transparent promise to our student athletes, the current ones and the recruits, of what we stand for, what they can expect when they come here, and part of that is full cost of attendance. As you may know, for years scholarships just covered room, board, tuition, fees, and books, and now there's that cost of attendance piece, of which is a formula calculated through our financial aid office. It's a federal formula. Every school calculates it and has been for years, but a lot more people are paying attention to it now.
I'll tell you who's paying attention to it are the recruits. These 23 young men who signed with Tech that we've already gotten to, and there could be one more before the end of the day. This is the first real recruiting class that knows they've got the 4-year guaranteed scholarship. They know they've got the full cost of attendance. And for the stars, the elite guys, there's some insurance initiatives as well that we can help them out, whereas 4 years ago that wasn't necessarily the case.
Right, right. Yeah, it's a new era, and all of our student athletes that are on some form of scholarship will benefit from it. And then we've put some other things in play to benefit our walk-ons, et cetera. But, yeah, it's a good time to be a young person and be a student athlete, and shoot, it's already great to come to Virginia Tech. Now it'll be even better.
1 year already. Did it fly by for you? It was January 22nd. Was that the date that you got the phone call?
Yeah, that was exactly it. And I know where I was standing. And it's been a whirlwind, but it's been great. I'm obviously honored to be here and hope to earn the right to do that for a long time. And thanks to our staff, I think we've had a great year, a lot to build on. And I'm really excited by the momentum. But I'm a better AD today than I was a year ago. And if I keep learning and growing, I'll be better next year too.
During the course of Signing Day Live, we've been running the promos for the Virginia Tech football schedule. And season tickets, the renewals will happen here early this spring, and the tickets will go on sale. That is vitally important. I think having, number one, the defending national champions here is great. And number two, to have a Monday night football game again with the Buckeyes coming in is just a tremendous draw for our team.
Yeah, and there has been a lot of talk about the schedule, and we certainly prefer to play on Saturdays and the occasional Thursday. But I tell you, when you can get a Monday night game that's national and a Friday night game, the exposure and the visibility, and obviously if you win it, the whole next day's highlights and all that. So the occasional weekday game that the ACC assigns us, we're going to make the best of it, and gives us a chance to promote Virginia Tech on a national stage.
There's the schedule. It starts with the Buckeyes and then Furman, two games that same week, and the home ACC games, Pitt October 3rd, NC State is the Friday night game, and then Duke and North Carolina wrap things up, and season tickets will go on sale later in the spring, but fans can log on and renew now and at least reserve.
That's right.
On HokieTickets.com.
We need them. Our fans made a huge difference at the UVA game and in the bowl game, so we need them. I know we need to do our part, but come in here, see the defending national champions. We've got good games, and they're spread out through September, October, November, and there's nothing like Lane Stadium, so we hope people will join us.
You know, I look at the list of these 23 kids that we've run through, and I look at this new building that is going up right outside your office, and I see the positive momentum that is happening here. It's really exciting. These kids, the 23 kids that we have already run through today, have certainly bought into it.
Yeah, it's a great era, and it takes more than one person. It's a lot of us, but that momentum's going, and we're not going to stop now.
Thanks for coming by, Whit.
All right. Thank you.
All right, don't go away. When our show continues, we are going to wrap things up. Chuck Cantor will rejoin me, Virginia Tech's Director of Player Personnel for football. We will tie a bow on Signing Day Live and wrap things up. Don't go away. Our show continues in a moment.
Subway, a great meal starts with a great sandwich on the new Simple 6 menu. Six of our best 6-inch subs, now in made just for you meals for just $6 each every day.
I got it made fresh at Subway.
Take your pick from six of our best subs, like the tender turkey breast, the Italian BMT, sweet onion chicken teriyaki, and more. With any bag of chips and a 21-ounce drink, all six are just $6 every day on the new Simple 6 menu.
I got it made fresh at Subway.
G&H Appliance has been proudly serving the valleys of Southwest Virginia since 1969, offering a great selection of quality brands with guaranteed savings. The knowledgeable and experienced professionals at G&H can help you find the appliance that fits your needs. G&H is a member of a nationwide buying group that will ensure savings on top products from Maytag, Whirlpool, and KitchenAid. Follow us on Facebook and Twitter. Trust someone who knows you and knows home appliances. Trust G&H Appliance. Nobody does it better.
Signing Day Live from Blacksburg, and the Hokies kick things off against Ohio State on Monday night, September 7th. There is the complete schedule for 2015. Ohio State, Furman at home. Then the Hokies travel to Purdue and East Carolina before getting into a big run of ACC games, starting with the Pittsburgh Panthers coming to Lane Stadium on October 3rd. Friday night against NC State, just 6 days later. Then the Hokies travel to Sun Life Stadium in October to battle the Miami Hurricanes. Duke at home, up the Chestnut Hill on Halloween weekend, down to Georgia Tech for that Thursday night game in November. Hokies wrap things up with two gigantic Coastal Division games, home against North Carolina, and then Thanksgiving Saturday at Scott Stadium against Virginia. You can renew your season tickets beginning on March 2nd. There's the website, bthokie/season ticks. You can, of course, always call the Virginia Tech ticket office for more information. We're wrapping things up on Signing Day Live. Bill Roth, Chuck Cantor rejoins me now, the Hokies Director of Player Personnel for football. What a exciting day it's been. You can really see the vibe, having Lefty and Steiny and Butt up out here. A good day for the Hokie Nation, isn't it?
Yeah, everybody's really fired up about the class that we got coming in. And, you know, a big thing on recruiting is the opportunity to get to improve your position at certain, you know, your team at certain positions. And I think we did that today. You know, I think it was, really good for our future, and we're excited.
But there is no downtime whatsoever. Recruiting for 2016 is already underway. What are our targets for next year?
Yeah, you know, the 16 class, you know, we've been readily attacking that and offering more guys, you know, by the day. And, we keep on going after that. You know, every year when we go through the recruiting cycle, there are going to be positions that we – you know, say, hey, this is going to be a position that we need maybe a few more guys at. So, every year in our class, you know, we're going to try and sign a quarterback. You know, we're going to try and sign a great running back every single year. And, we feel this year we signed a really good running back, in McLeese. And, the receiver position, that's going to be one of those positions next year that we target. And, there are going to be multiple guys that we look to bring in this upcoming class to – offensive line class for this upcoming year, that's going to be another multiple position for us. You know, we're always looking to bring in some great defensive ends. The defensive tackle position, you know, Luther Matty will be, you know, heading on to the NFL after next year, with the same with Corey Marshall. So that'll be another position that we're, you know, looking to get another great one in there. Those guys have had great careers so far for us. And, you know, the linebacker position, you know, that's going to be a, you know, big position for us, you know, with Chase heading off this year. And, you know, we got, you know, that'll be a position for the future. And then this is DBU, so, you know, we got to continue to, you know, get guys at that position. So, you know, those will be the targets for us. And, it won't be probably the biggest recruiting class next year in overall numbers. But, you know, we'll just based on our scholarships, but we'll, we're really going to go after and, attack it.
All right, we ran through 23 young men here today. Is there a chance that we may see one or two more before the end of today that we announce?
Yeah, if it's not today, there's always opportunities here in the future, to potentially bring in additional guys to our roster. And, we're always out there looking for, maybe a guy to pop late, maybe even a, spring recruit, and one of our coaches comes upon, young man, and, if it's a junior college or a high school, maybe got overlooked and, maybe he's further developing, this spring. So
there have been some really exciting developments as we look at Tech's football program. Bud Foster getting the contract extension was huge. I don't think any Hokie will debate that. And then every day we walk in here and we see the indoor facility rising into the sky here at Tech. And then we see a guy like Cam Chancellor make the Pro Bowl again and go back to the Super Bowl. There's a lot of positive momentum going on that makes it exciting, doesn't it?
Yeah, we're really excited about everything that's here. And, but before we get off the air here, I just want to thank all the people that were a part of, help bring this, 2015 class together. From Thomas Gary, who's a director of high school relations for us, Christy Verneil, who's helped us immensely here with the process, and just all the academic support staff, Sarah Armstrong's entire crew, and just everybody, even the dining services here. We have the number one dining services in the entire country on our campus, and that's a great opportunity for us. They do a great job for us on those official visits. So it's a pretty tough place to turn down when you have lobster and steak on the dinner menu. So
no doubt. Well, congratulations. Great work.
Yes, sir.
It's a tremendous first year here at Tech, Chuck. We're so glad you're here, and the results speak for themselves. What a tremendous haul here for the Hokies.
Thank you.
That wraps up Signing Day Live for 2015. Thanks so much for joining us. We look forward to seeing many of you tonight at Tech Talk Live with Buzz Williams. Hokie basketball at Castle Coliseum, Florida State, Saturday afternoon. Georgia Tech is here on Monday night. And we look forward to seeing you during the Hokie Club during the spring tour as well. If you're just joining us, this entire program will be archived on Hokies Extra, so you can go back and hear what our coaches have to say about our 2015 class. Thanks so much for joining us, and so long from Blacksburg.